you're a sky, 'cause you're a sky full of stars. I'm gonna give you my heart.
Weight loss, their outcomes were worse when it comes to quality of life, physical functioning, role functioning, emotional functioning, as well as social functioning. They had worse fatigue, as well as social eating and social contact because of the severe side effects and the malnutrition that is accompanied with this treatment, usually chemo and radiotherapy. And we have weight change before presentation also associated with poor outcomes in GI cancer. So.
It's not only recognized in the scientific literature, also you see that it gets now a lot of attention in the more public.
Suy mòn quá rõ, còn da với xương thông thì nó lại tương quan quá kém, bệnh nhân rất khó mà thoát khỏi những cái biến chứng hoặc là tình trạng đáp ứng điều trị ung thư nó kém.
Có 36 bệnh nhân có tình trạng sụn cân trước mổ tần suất khoảng 95%.
Tôi hỏi có cái sự liên quan gì giữa cái giảm cân nặng và cái liều điều trị chất không? Xin các giáo sư chia sẻ kinh nghiệm.
As a medical oncologist, when we treat patients with cancer, we base our systemic therapies on the body surface area. Body surface area, as you know, is height and weight. For an ideal patient, an ideal person, patients who are wasted, patients who are cachectic and losing weight, their body surface area is going to be less, and they're going to lose a lot of muscle mass as well, so they'll be sarcopenic. So they will not be able to tolerate the chemotherapy. They will have exaggerated side effects also just because of the weight loss itself, but also because of cytokines and prostaglandin E2 anti-inflammatory effect. They will have increased toxicities from the systemic therapy as well. So patients who are sarcopenic and patients who are cachectic are less likely to respond to the chemotherapy. They are more likely to get less of a dose of chemotherapy and more likely to get the required number of cycles of systemic therapy as well. So hence, the impact on the outcomes, whether it's disease-free survival or overall survival or even response rates would be less. They're not ideal patients. Their performance status would be also lower, so they might not be able to tolerate the therapy as well.
Yeah, not too much to add. I think this is very clear. So there is a very strong relation indeed between weight loss and muscle loss, and ultimately the relation between muscle loss and performance status is without any debate. I think also it has been shown by all the studies that there is a clear impact of the nutritional intervention with EBA on physical performance as well. So that is, I think, a clear way to go. Combining that with physical exercise actually would even enhance the effect. So it's also something I think to keep in mind when you Think about your patients, think about the multimodality approach, and make sure that your patients continue to be active and continue to be eating to have to ultimately the best performance of the patient. Just got